Hi, I'm Norman Wildberger, and this video introduces you and invites you to a new way of thinking about geometry and trigonometry. I've now posted a series of videos under the WildTrig name in which I show you a new way of thinking about trigonometry, and I think it's time that I properly introduce myself and properly sort of outline the scope of this series. First of all, I'm Norman Wildberger. I'm an associate professor, professional mathematician at the University of New South Wales in Sydney, Australia. I'm originally Canadian. I was an undergraduate at the University of Toronto and did a PhD at Yale University. I've also taught at Stanford University and the University of Toronto. I'm by training a harmonic analyst, but about 10 years ago I became very interested in foundational issues about geometry, and I now have a new way of thinking about the subject that I want to present to you. There are really three fundamental branches of mathematics: arithmetic, geometry, and algebra. Of course, these subjects really overlap to a large extent. Geometry, which was for centuries or millennium one of the really fundamental parts of the subject, has really fallen by the wayside in the last century. And I would like to contribute to a reawakening of the beauty and the importance of this subject, especially at the public school and the high school level, where it needs to be taught in a new and better way. So my approach to geometry is, simplistically, is to start with the intersection where it combines with arithmetic and algebra. And it turns out that in this intersection, in this common ground, there is trigonometry. Not the trigonometry that you learn in school these days, but a different kind of trigonometry that I'm going to teach you, called rational trigonometry. It really sits right in the center of all these things. So my approach is to start there and to work out and develop geometry in this new sort of central and simplified point of view. The main source reference is my recent book called Divine Proportions: Rational Trigonometry to Universal Geometry, which gives a thorough and systematic account and development of this new way of thinking about geometry and trigonometry. It's available online at the publisher's website or at Amazon.com. And you may download Chapter 1 and other chapters from my personal web pages at the University of New South Wales. So I intend this series to be one where scientists, high school teachers, the general public with an interest in mathematics can follow along. So why do we need a new way of thinking about geometry? Euclid's fabulously important book, The Elements, was the main structure for geometry for 2,000 years. But around 100 years ago, people started realizing that there were cracks and logical flaws in Euclid. One of the very first things that Euclid does demonstrates this. He shows how to construct an equilateral triangle on a base. And he does it by taking his compass, fixing it there, and drawing an arc of a circle like that, and then drawing another circle with center there through this point. And then he says that all you need to do is look at the intersection of those two circles and then join them, and you get an equilateral triangle. The logical flaw, which had sort of went unnoticed for millennia, was that how do we really know, apart from the picture, that these two circles that we've drawn actually intersect? Bit of a subtle business. Here's a more sophisticated version of the problems you can get into by relying on pictures. Okay, here's a proof of the wrong fact that every triangle is equilateral. I'm going to try to convince you that every triangle is equilateral. So what you do is you take this triangle ABC, and you construct the angle bisector at C, and the perpendicular bisector of this segment. So you take the midpoint and go up perpendicularly. Now, if you drop this perpendicular here and this perpendicular here, you can see that these two triangles are congruent, so that this side and this side must be the same. By elementary geometry, this triangle and this triangle are also congruent, so this side and this side must be the same. But then we also know from this triangle that these are the same, and therefore this triangle and this triangle are also congruent, so that side is the same as that side. Conclusion: this and this together is the same as that and that together, so AC equals BC. It's an example of wrong reasoning, but it's not clear where the flaw is. But it's because we've been following pictures, and Euclid's geometry is full of that kind of thing. This approach of Euclid, relying on pictures and constructions with ruler and compass, is also often called a synthetic approach to geometry. I remind you, Euclid was around 300 BC. There's another really important development in geometry that happened in the 1600s due to Descartes and Fermat, which is the introduction of coordinates in geometry. This was a completely new way of thinking, where we look at the plane in terms of a series of grid lines that allow us to specify locations by coordinates. Then something like a circle, instead of just having a vague pictorial definition, can be described completely algebraically by an equation like this. So the picture can be replaced by algebra, and the algebra represents the picture. Incredibly powerful idea, really one of the main ideas in science in the last 500 years, this basic idea of coordinatizing geometry. However, it never really solved the main problem, which because the notions of distance and angle in this framework are not algebraic. They're transcendental, meaning you have to go beyond algebraic methods. So our approach is to stick with Descartes' reformulation of Euclidean geometry and insist that everything be done completely 100% algebraically. So we're going to replace distance and angle with new concepts. And we're going to restate all of trigonometry, we're going to reformulate all of geometry, including projective geometry, hyperbolic geometry, spherical geometry, chromogeometry. We're going to reformulate all of these things in a new way. The result is that our new approach is going to unify arithmetic, geometry, and algebra. We're going to bring these subjects together. For a high school teacher, the benefits are that the subject becomes a lot simpler, easier to teach, easier to learn. Applications are going to become more accurate. The whole subject becomes much more watertight and logical. And, last but not least, it becomes a lot more beautiful. Geometry is really a beautiful subject. It's one of the high points of human intellectual activity. And I really want people to understand and appreciate, even ordinary people who are not mathematicians, the beauty and the elegance of this wonderful subject. So I hope you're going to join me for this adventure. We're going to have a new way of thinking about geometry. We're going to start by thinking about trigonometry, reformulate trigonometry, and then we're going to go on to these more advanced areas, but I want to keep the level of these videos always at more or less the same elementary level so that a broad audience can learn from these. I hope you're going to join me. I'm Norman Wildberger. Thanks for listening.